So while we looked at shutter speeds, now let's talk about the concept of aperture, which basically, again, is nothing else but the opening that lets in the light into the sensor. So as I said before, aperture is basically dependent on irradiance. Irradiance on a sensor is the amount of light captured and is proportional to the area of the aperture opening. So of course, the amount of light that's going to go through the aperture is depending on how big the area is, small area, larger area. Traditionally, of course, when you just do the simple math, you can see that the area really depends on pi f over 2n, where f is the focal length and n is the number that we'll talk about in a second. Here, f is the focal length of the lens being used. And of course, you can start now looking at it as how does one compute the area of something here? And based on this, can we actually now figure out what is the diameter of the aperture? So of course, an area of a circle is pi r squared, where r would be the radius. This is replacing the radius by this term here. Usually, in most cameras, you'll actually see the aperture number, or even if you look at any of the details of the metadata of your image, the aperture number would be actually written as a capital N and usually written as f over n. Let's look at this in a little bit more detail. So the focal length f and aperture number are known. Now, one of the interesting things to note is aperture number is given irrespective. It gives the irradiance of what's hitting the sensor irrespective of the lens being used, because it's the f that's dependent on the lens. N is, of course, the size of the aperture. So for example, when somebody gives you a lens f2.0, on a 50 millimeter lens, the aperture would be 25 millimeters. So an f over 2 aperture number for a 50 millimeter lens is going to basically say that the aperture size is 25 millimeters. So for a f over 2n number, for a 200 millimeter lens, the aperture would be 100 millimeters. So this should start telling us that if the f number is low for a telephoto lens, that basically means that it should be a much bigger, wider lens. So here I'm just showing you the lens that I had earlier shown you folks. And this is, of course, a standard telephoto lens. Has a lot of range and goes from 70 to 300 millimeter focal length. It also has the F numbers written here from 1.4 to 5.6. And basically, if I wanted the F number to be low on this lens, I would have had to have, of course, a much bigger lens. This one is, of course, limited by the size of this. And of course, the size, this depends exactly on my aperture, has to be smaller than this. So if I really want a low aperture number, I would need a thicker lens. And you may have seen sports photographers carry those huge lenses out on the sidelines to be able to capture images.